Hi everyone, welcome you all in my YouTube channel. Dear friends, I am AKSRajveer and in today's class, we are going to study all about Ralph Waldo Emerson. दोस्तों आप सबके रिक्वेस्ट थे कि मैं जो भी वीडियोस बनाऊं वो सब मैं बाइलिंगुअल बनाऊं यानी कि इंग्लिश में या फिर हिंदी में दोनों लैंग्वेजेस में तो दोस्तों आज का ये वीडियो जो राल्फ वाल्डो इमर्सन पर मैं आप सबको प्रोवाइड करने जा रहा हूं ये दोस्तों इंग्लिश में रहेगा और पिछला वीडियो आई हैव ऑलरेडी अपलोडेड इन हिंदी सो अगर आप उसे देखना चाहते हैं तो दोस्तों लिंक दिया हुआ है डिस्क्रिप्शन में आप उसे वॉच कर सकते हैं तो दोस्तों अगर आपने मेरे चैनल को अभी तक सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया तो देर किस बात की प्लीज सब्सक्राइब कर दीजिए चैनल को और बेल आइकॉन को जरूर चेक कर लीजिए चलिए दोस्तों राल्फ वाल्डो इमर्सन इन इंग्लिश तो दोस्तों ये जो वीडियो है आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू दिस इन दिस वीडियो ऑल अबाउट राल्फ वाल्डो इमर्सन इन इंग्लिश सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो Dear friends, first of all, I would like to tell you a little bit about Ralph Waldo Emerson because this video is totally based on his life. He was born 1803 and he was died in 1882. And dear friends, I would like to tell you, in this lifespan, he has worked a lot. Being an American, He worked as an essayist, as a poet, as a philosopher, and his career that was started with a Unitarian minister. But he achieved a lot. He got worldwide fame as a lecturer and as an author. So, dear friends, his essays like Self-Reliance, History, The Oversoul and The Fate, these are really, really important because these lectures gave him name and fame. And his views on Romanticism, Neoplatonism and Kantism and Hinduism are really, really important. And Emerson developed a metaphysics of process, an epistemology of moods and an existentialist ethic of self-importance. He influenced generations of Americans and his friend like Henry David Thoreau, John Dewey, and in Europe, he influenced Friedrich Nietzsche and others. And such Emersonian theme as power, fate, and uses of poetry and history, and the critique of Christianity, Ralph Waldo Emerson puts his name in famous personality. So dear friends, in this video, as I have already told you, I'm going to tell you all about his life in detail. So he was born in Boston and he was son of William and Ruth Haskins Emerson. His father died in 1811 and he joined in 1812 after death of his father. He joined the school, you can say the local public school. And after that, in 1817, he joined Harvard College. There he studied three languages, basically Greek, Latin, English, and history and rhetoric as a subject. He also published a journal entitled The Wild Word that was published in 1820 The Wild Word and after that after getting his graduation degree from Harvard and after getting his graduation degree from Harvard he started teaching career with his brother William's school for young ladies in Boston and then you can see He also had some belief because his father was a clergyman and he also adopted the work of a clergyman. And then after that, you can see in 1829, he got married with Ellen Tucker. And after that, you can see, a big incident takes place in his life. And this was the death of his beloved, or you can say wife. She died young at 19. And dear friends, after death of his wife, Ellen Tucker, he sailed to Europe 1832. There he got introduced with a number of personality like William Wordsworth, Samuel Taylor Coleridge, and then J.S. Mill, Thomas Carlyle. These were the prominent figure at that time in England. And after that, he also started a career as a lecturer. The second marriage takes place in his life in 1835. He got married with Lydian Jackson. Lydian Jackson, she was his second wife. And after that, he published one of his important work entitled Nature, that appeared in 1836. So dear friends, as a poet, he started establishing his position in American society, because you know him for transcendentalism. He is one of the most important figure, and this you can also see his other works like Self-Reliance, The Oversoul, Circle, and History. These are his prominent, or you can say important, essays. And then his child named Waldo, he was only 5 years old, died of scarlet fever, and this was a major incident, you can say a life-changing incident, from where he started mourning for his child. And he has also written some beautiful poem for his child. And you can also see his other essays like The Poet, Experience, and then Nominalist and Realist. These are also really, really important, because he was famous as a lecturer. And then you can see he published his collection of essays, where you can find a number of great personality like Plato, Swedenborg, Montaigne, Goethe, and Napoleon. About these personalities he has written in his work Representative Man. This was the collection where you can find a number of essays on very famous personalities. And after that, you can see he was also a great supporter of anti-slavery, because he want to give something like freedom, like existence, individuality. He want to explore his individuality, and you can see his existentialist philosophy in his works. And he was also known as Sage of Concord. Do you know why he was known as Sage of Concord? Because he was living in Concord, Boston, New York, Philadelphia. And it was the time of 70s when his home got fired. Everything, almost everything was burnt, but his friends helped him a lot and for giving him a fund, and his house was restored. You can also see his another work like English Traits and The Conduct of Life, where you can see culture and faith. These are important essays. And you can also see his work like Society and Solitude. And after that, it was the period of, as I have already told you, 1970s, when he was totally in dilemma. जो भी वो याद करता था उसे एवरीथिंग लगभग लगभग भूल जाता था, इवन कि उसको अपना नाम. बट वो कहते भी थे कि आई एम इमर्सन, आई नोज एवरीथिंग बट आई कांट अंडरस्टैंड, बिकॉज ही वॉज इन अ काइंड ऑफ इन अ पोजिशन वेयर ही कांट अंडरस्टैंड एवरीथिंग. सो एट दैट टाइम ही स्टॉप्ड राइटिंग कैरियर, एंड आफ्टर दैट ही स्टार्टेड ट्रेवल टू यूरोप एंड इजिप्ट. And his entire life from 1803 to 1882. It was the year 1882 was the year when his life ended. In going to cover with you the other aspect, the other important aspect from Ralph Waldo Emerson's life and his work. So thank you all, and stay tuned with me. We will meet in next class. Have a good day.